Public or private? Picking and changing the Windows network setting. Hi, everyone. Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. One of the most confusing aspects of Windows networking is the concept of private and public networks. When you set up a network, typically when installing Windows or the first time you make a connection on a new network adapter, Windows makes an assumption about which you want. Sometimes that assumption is wrong. Depending on what you do later, Windows may offer to change it. Or not. I'll review what these network types mean and how to switch from one to the other. The easiest way to change your network type is to use Windows PowerShell. You have to run it as administrator. We're going to do that here in Windows 11. I'll right-click on Start, click on Terminal Admin, and since I have Terminal configured to come up with Command Prompt, I'm going to go ahead and have it fire up an additional Windows PowerShell instead. The command to run first is get net connection profile. Now, this displays information about the current configuration of the network. In this case, what we're looking for is the name of the network. In this example, my name is the very creative network. It's this line right here. Okay. Notice, though, that the network category here is private. What we want to do in this example is change it. So, to change the network category, we'll enter the following command. This is the set net connection profile command. Dash name means network name. If you have multiple networks, if you've got multiple network adapters, you may have more than one. So this identifies which one you're going to operate on. And then what we're changing is the network category, and we're going to change it to public. Boom, we're done. If I now rerun that get network connection profile, it now shows me that the network category has been changed to public. Okay, great. We now know how to change the network category. We would run the set net connection profile, as I've just done, with either the network category public or private. Now let's understand what they mean. Think of the terms as defining not whether you want your computer to be private or public, but rather it's defining the nature of the network you're connecting to. When you're on a private network, the implication is that you can more readily trust the other machines on that same network. Your network at home is a good example. All the machines you have connected to the same router are on the same network, and you can usually trust that all of them are well behaved. This is a good candidate for a private network. When you're on a public network, the implication is that you shouldn't trust other computers on the same network. Connecting to a very literally public network, say Wi-Fi at the airport or a hotel or coffee shop, is a good example of a public network. You don't know who else is connected to the same network you are, so you don't know whether they've been practicing good security hygiene or even if they might have malicious intent. When Windows treats a network as public, a firewall blocks connections from external sources. That means that a random person can't find your computer, they can't connect to your computer, and therefore they can't steal files from it. When Windows treats a network as private, the firewall allows these kinds of connections. The most common time this comes up is when trying to access a network share or network printer on one computer from another. If the network on the first computer is configured as public, it won't work. So, which one do you want? Well, it's actually pretty simple. Use a private network to connect to devices on your home network, particularly if you plan to use Windows file sharing to copy files between them. Use a public network to connect to networks you don't control, such as when you're traveling. And as I mentioned earlier, it is possible to have multiple network adapters, say both an Ethernet connection and a Wi-Fi connection. They can be of different network types. For example, if you connect your laptop via Ethernet at home and then use Wi-Fi only when you're out and about, You can set the Ethernet network as private and the Wi-Fi as public. This allows you to share files and printers with other devices at home while keeping your computer more protected elsewhere. You don't have to remember to switch between the two. Bottom line here is that if you're not sure, generally you don't need to do anything. On the other hand, if you're having difficulty with some networking operations like file and printer sharing, you might consider whether the network type, public or private, could be contributing to the issue. If so, now you know how to change it and what some of the implications might be. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/185051. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.